Welcome back into Daytime Alabama. Wanted to show the women of Alabama some love. Mia Hamm was born in Selma. Of course, she was part of that great 1996 Olympic gold medalist soccer team. Did you know she still holds the record, though? The leading scorer of men and women in soccer in the world. Pretty impressive.
How impressive of a player she was. Mm-hmm. Tons of goals scored. We're talking here about money. A lot of goal setting, planning. Imagine the hard work that it took.
Yeah.
A lot of us need to do some hard work with our finances. Here's some great tips to help us get on down that road. Here at Church of the Highlands, catching up with Dave Scobey of Crown Ministries. Good to see you again, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Here at Highlands, you were part of a financial freedom seminar.
Correct.
All right, that's kind of what you all offer. I know every viewer wants to be there. You know, we're not in bondage because we want to be.
You know,
it just happens to us and how we respond. So let's talk about maybe some of the mistakes and the consistent mistakes that you see as you travel around the nation and helping folks with their finances.
Well, as a matter of fact, during one of our sessions in the seminar, we teach that very thing. We teach the common mistakes that people are making, but more importantly, we teach the remedies to those mistakes.
Good.
And if I had to prioritize the common mistake, it's having a short-term versus a long-term focus.
Okay.
The media is out there bombarding us. They're saying, you got to have it now.
Right.
Oh, by the way, and here's the monthly payment.
Yeah.
If you can only pay this, we have a tendency to look very short-term and not think about the impact of that decision and what it's going to do down the road. Mm-hmm. So short-term versus long-term focus. How do you get a long-term focus? You start doing some analysis. For instance, somebody wants to buy a refrigerator.
Right.
Well, obviously, price shop. But then before you buy it, if you buy it on credit, figure out how much it's going to cost you in total if you were going to buy that refrigerator. For example, if I went and bought a refrigerator at one of the major national department stores where you might find a good refrigerator, mm-hmm. and I took them up on their offer to pay a minimum amount of payment, I will pay about 3.5 times the price of that refrigerator. Here's the point.
Wow.
If I'm shopping for a $1,000 refrigerator and I walked into that store and they had a price tag on that of $3,500, would I be motivated to buy it?
Not even close.
Shouldn't be.
Yeah.
But we buy it because we don't think about the fact that in the long term, it's going to cost us a whole lot of money if we don't have the cash available to buy it.
Yeah. What is the consistent theme and story of someone who has a lifetime of sound financial living versus the opposite?
What is the theme?
Yeah, you know, I mean, what is the consistency? I mean, do you think it is things like a plan?
Oh, absolutely. For someone that manages money well and sees money accumulate rather than disappear, mm-hmm. very simple. It's having a concrete plan in place and making the business and the purchase decisions based on the plan.
Yeah.
It's not a haphazard go through the life impulse. It's making decisions based on information. That's the key, and that's one thing I emphasize in the seminar, is making fact-based decisions rather than emotional decisions.
Right, yeah. And I can just hear viewers at home saying, you know, Dave, I'm worried about next week, much less next year.
Yeah.
What to that response?
Well, I would say simply stop and do some analysis of where you are.
Right.
Do you have enough money to pay the bills that are coming in next week or next month?
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you don't, then first step is stop borrowing.
Yeah.
Cold turkey.
Right.
Make a decision, and it has to be a family decision because sometimes kids can help you spend the money.
Right, yeah.
Make a family decision that we're going to stop. We're not going to dig ourselves in a deeper hole. The quickest way to get out of debt is by not incurring any additional debt.
Right.
Then once you stop and you know that you can maintain status quo, then you start looking at, okay, how can I start saving? How can I reduce spending? What are some ways to raise cash? Is there anything I can sell?
Yeah. Okay.
For example, if somebody's got a vehicle that they could sell, mm-hmm. not only would they get the cash from that vehicle, but they wouldn't have to buy that next license plate. They wouldn't have to pay the insurance premium. They wouldn't have to do maintenance on it.
Right.
So it magnifies itself. Yeah. So you just start doing that analysis and you start making decisions based on information.
Take that first step. If our viewers want more information about you all or Crown, how's the best way to get that?
Simplest way is crown.org.
Yeah, it's a fantastic ministry. Check it out, crown.org. It's great to meet you.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
You bet.